Everyone, so today I'm here with the next chapter in GK, that is chapter number 16 of your class 8 GK book. Okay, so in chapter number 16, the green revolution. What is the green revolution, children? It's a process of technological development of agricultural techniques. Okay, agriculture mein kranti aayi is period mein. Better quality of seeds, produce हुए, then advanced technologies आए, जो कि agricultural production, there was increase in the production in the agriculture. Okay, so it began in Mexico in 1944. So there are some facts about Green Revolution. Okay, we'll read the questions one by one. And then we'll just fill the appropriate suitable answer in the blank provided. Okay, so the very first question: in ancient times, farmers dashed from one species to onto another to obtain desirable qualities in the next generation of plants. So what did farmer brush? They used to brush pollen hota hai na flowers mein. Okay, now the next question: dash and dash are short stemmed plants of wheat. They grow very fast and give huge yields. Yields means, what do you mean by the term yield? Y-I-E-L-D. Yield means production. Understood? So the answer is gains and nugains. Okay, these are the short stem plant. मतलब इनकी जो stem जो है वो बहुत छोटी होती है. Understood? Question number 3. In 1876, Charles Darwin discovered that dash makes plants less vigorous. Vigorous means less active, you can say. Okay. So the answer is, what is the answer? Inbreeding. Okay. Come to question number 4. Dash between different strains of plants produce healthier plants. So what is between different strains of plant, different types of plant, or different, you can say, species of plants produce healthier plants, children? Answer is cross breeding. Okay. Then in the early 1900s, dash scientists observed that they could improve the protein content of corn by inbreeding, but the production was poor. So the answer is American scientist. Okay, dash. Okay, so let me choose random questions. Okay, question number 10. Farmers nowadays use 10 times as much dash fertilizers as in 1960. So what do they use? 10 times as much what? So they use what kind of fertilizers, children? They use nitrogenous fertilizers, which is, nitrogenous fertilizers are very good for the plants. Okay, then come to question number 14. The Green Revolution in India was initiated by, means it was started by whom? Started by C. Subramaniam, M.S. Swaminathan, B.P. Pal. Okay, with the import of 18,000 tons of the dwarf wheat seed in 1966. So these were the three people, personalities, who started or who initiated Green Revolution in India. Clear? Then come to the next question, that is question number 16. There are three basic elements of Green Revolution: bring more land under dash. So under what? Land is used for what, children? Yes? Land is used for what? What is land used for? Who will say me? Yes? The land is used for cultivation. Kheti karne kaam aata hai na land. Understood? So bring more land under cultivation. Then practice what? Cropping. Practice double cropping. Double cropping kya hoti hai? Ek plot of land, piece of land pe aap दो अलग अलग क्रॉप्स आप ग्रो कर सकते हो एक ही टाइम में. तो दैट इज व्हाट, दैट इज, दिस प्रैक्टिस इज टर्म्ड एज डबल क्रॉपिंग ऑन द एग्जिस्टिंग फार्म लैंड एंड यूज सीड्स विथ इम्प्रूव्ड डैश. तो सीड्स विथ इम्प्रूव्ड व्हाट? इम्प्रूव्ड जीन्स. ओके, फॉर द बेटर प्रोडक्शन for the better yield, for the increased yield. Understood? Then come to question number 17. The Indian Council for Agricultural Research was reorganized in 1965 and then again in dash. So which year was it started? It was started in 1973. Understood? The Indian Council for Agricultural Research developed new strains of high yield variety dash mainly of wheat and rice and also of millet and corn. So what was it? It was of seeds. Understood? High yield variety seeds jinse zyada jisse zyada production ho sake. Are you getting me? So this was it. Clear? Now just fill this chapter and write it, learn it by heart and write it in your copy as well. Clear? So now let's move to the next chapter, that is chapter number 30. So chapter number 30 is, what is chapter number 30? Which chapter is chapter number 30? Chapter number 30 is astronomy. What is astronomy? The word astronomy has been taken from the Greek word astron. Now what does astron means? Astron means stars. Okay, sorry, astron means star. Astronomy is the scientific study of heavenly bodies like the sun, moon and stars. Complete the following statements on astronomy. So let's see. Modern astronomy began with the Italian astronomer. So what was the name of the Italian astronomer? Galileo. Okay. In 1609, he heard of the telescope made by the Dutchman Hans Lippershey. He improved on it and made an instrument that could magnify up to dash times. So that could magnify up to 30 times. Okay. Now, in 1670, Dash invented a new instrument, the reflector telescope. A large concave mirror was used for this purpose. So, who invented? Newton invented a reflector telescope. Clear? Then come to which question? So let's move to question number 7. Okay. The dash consists of large metal reflector fitted with an antenna. The metal reflector collects and focuses radio energy onto the antenna, which can be tuned to any desired frequency. So what consists of these things? The radio telescope. Clear? Then come to question number 9. When Explorer 1 was launched in 1958 by US with a special instrument, two donut-shaped regions of intense radiation around the Earth were discovered. This was how Dash started. So what started? Satellite astronomy. Okay, then come to question number 10. The invisible rays given out by stars and galaxies belong to the same family of rays. They are all electromagnetic waves and form what is called the dash. So it is called the electromagnetic spectrum. The question number 11. The 11-ton dash built at a cost of US$1.5 billion is the most powerful optical telescope even developed. It was launched in 1990. So the answer is Hubble telescope. Clear? So I have just not discussed all the questions. Okay, I have just discussed the main questions. All the questions are important, but I have discussed few questions. So it's your work to just write the answers of all the questions on your own. Okay, and learn it by heart. Clear? Now let's move to chapter number 27. Chapter number 27 is all about scientific terms for an exam. There are two columns, column A, column B. Column A consists of descriptions and column B consists of the scientific terms. Okay, for an example, inference, albedo, astrophotography, entropy, dementia, plasma, then eutrophication, prion, solar radiation. Okay, so these are the scientific terms. For an example, what is inference? Okay. What is an inferrin? Inferrin are the proteins that are produced in the body. Okay. Produced in the body against viral infection. Then for an example, what is dementia? Dementia refers to the deterioration of personality and intellect that can result from disease or damage to the brain. Memory loss ho jata hai usme, impaired mental process, personality changes, confusion, lack of inhibition, and a deterioration in personal care and hygiene are its characteristics. Means the person who is suffering from dementia is not able to think properly. Okay, understood. Then you have next term, plasma. Now, what is plasma, children? Yes, plasma is an ionized gas produced at extremely high temperatures, as in the sun and other stars. Okay, so it contains positive negative charges in almost equal numbers. Clear? Now, what is eutrophication? Eutrophication is a process by which a stream or lake becomes rich in inorganic nutrients by runoff from the land or by artificial means. Now, what do you mean by solar radiation? So, hum log baat karte hai na, solar radiation. So, what is it? Okay, solar radiation is radiation given off by the sun. Solar, that means it has to be related to sun. Okay, which consists mainly of visible light, ultraviolet radiation, and infrared radiation. Along the whole spectrum of electromagnetic waves is present, from radio waves to X-rays. Clear? So these were some of the terms. Okay, you'll match the terms with their description and learn it. Clear? And at the same time, you'll write the answers in your copy. Clear, children? Now let's move to next chapter, that is chapter number 25, computer virus. Now, what is a computer virus? We all know what is a computer. Now, what is virus? Virus is anything, you know, that hinders or prevents anything. So, what is computer virus? Computer virus is a virus that enters computer, okay, that is found in computer and prevent or hinders the working of a computer. Okay, that damages the system of a computer, you can say. So, that is computer virus. Okay. So, a computer virus is usually dash and can corrupt data ko kharab kar sakta hai, overwrite files or use up system resources and slow it down in the process. So, what is it? It is useful or harmful, children? It is harmful. Understood? Then come to the next question. Some viruses may merely disturb you, like ask you to key in certain dash to continue or pop up a message on the screen. So what is it? Messages. Understood? Answer is messages. Then come to question number 3. Viruses are usually written by rogue programmers to create trouble. Question number 4. Dash viruses infect the boot sector of disk. So what kind of viruses? Boot sector viruses. Okay. Let's discuss question number 6. Dash viruses store a single virus copy in a certain area on the disk. So, what kind of virus is it? It is cluster virus. Okay, or cluster viruses. Clear? Then come to question number 10. Question number 10. A dash virus infects files only when you modify or create files. So, what kind of virus? Slow infecting viruses. Okay, so this chapter is all about computer viruses and it's very, very interesting. Okay, it will give you lots of information regarding viruses, how it is infected. Understood? So, that's all. Clear? Now, let's move to the last chapter, that is chapter number 24. Useful trees. Okay, so as we all know that trees are very useful and important for us. as they give us a number of useful things. Okay, so there are description of some trees. Okay, for example, you have sycamore, palm tree, aspen, ash tree, then Norway maple, false acacia, silver birch, pussy willow, oak tree. So these are the trees, and you can see the picture over here. You can see the picture of palm tree, oak tree, silver birch, sycamore, pussy willow, ash tree. Okay, so palm tree is what? What is palm tree? It belongs to, it belongs to an ancient group of plants. Okay, its fossils have been found dating back to the time of dinosaurs. So you can just imagine how old is this tree. Okay, then you have second picture, that is of oak tree. Okay, so oak tree is, where is it found? It is found in temperate regions or in Tasmania. Clear? Then next picture you have, next picture is of silver birch. Silver birch, it grows on cliffs, ruins and infertile soil. You can see in the picture silver birch. Okay, then the next picture is of sycamore. This is found mainly in deciduous forest at high elevation. Elevation means at high heights. Okay, and what is it used to make? It is used to make furniture and tools. Why? Because it is hardwood. Okay, and hardwood ki kya speciality rehti hai? It is hard and durable. Bahut time tak chalta hai. Therefore, the furniture and tools are made up of sycamore tree. Then next you have pussy willow. Okay, pussy willow, as you can see, it's a small tree. Understood? It grows in riverine woods alongside streams. Then the last picture you have is of ash tree. Okay, ash tree is again a species of deciduous trees that grow in much of northern Eurasia and North America. And what is it made? What is it used to make, children? It is used once it was used to make tennis racket, axe handles, and oars. Clear? So this was all about chapter number 24, useful trees. Clear? Fill the answers in the blank provided and again learn this chapter properly, as the exams will be conducted as soon as possible. So that time you won't be getting time to learn all the chapters at once. So keep learning. Okay, every day one chapter. If you learn one chapter every day, then I think you'll able to cover up. Clear? And then you won't be, you won't have to find ways and means to just copy or cheat the answers from the book. Clear? So just be honest with yourself and learn the chapter. And please write the whatever chapters have been discussed, whatever chapters have been given as your homework, please fill the chapters in the book, as well as write those chapters in the copy also. Clear? In a good handwriting. So that's all for today. Thank you, children.